that goes with it. These two, the current world champions, going to the Olympics by rights. Along with Evandro and Pedro, they're currently also leaders in terms of points scored in the provisional rankings through March 19, with 7,000 ranking points. That would make them the number one seeds for the Games when they come in Rio in August. Away we go with the men's gold medal match here on the FIVB Beach Volleyball World Tour and the Victoria Open. Brazil in black serving, Italy in green receiving, and it's an ace serve start for Bruno as Lupo is left floundering. For those of you just joining us, this should be an absolute belter. Two teams that ask for and give no quarter. Oh, what a pickup from Bruno. And another good one as it doesn't come back over though, and a huge statement of intent from Bruno. As he goes scurrying across what is a very sandy court. This beach, unlike most that the players are used to on the tour, one, because we are actually on a beach. More often than not now, the sand is imported and it's played in city centres, such like. And this sand is really quite coarse. It's almost like pink Himalayan salt. And there are plenty of shells around, although most of those have been cleared away from the court. It has been watered heavily because of the heat. Has compacted a little as a result. Lupo gets that up and Nikolai wraps it off of Allison's block. Allison had issues yesterday with his attacking through what we call indoors position four. Trying to go cross-court on a slightly lower set and was either putting it in the net or putting it off the net and out. So we'll be hoping that he's got that organised today. One thing he certainly won't be seeing as it is beach volleyball is a two-man block. Although, having said that, it has happened on occasion when in the middle of a rally, players suddenly forget where they are. And both decide, well, we've got nothing to lose here and put up a block. It can be quite entertaining. Embarrassing for the attacker if he does get put down. Usually embarrassing for the blockers as the ball is rolled into the empty court. So at the end change, Brazil off to a flyer, leading by 5-2. And the Italians are scrambling at the moment, all to no avail. Good dig. And a great swing from Bruno. Just showing why he's a world championship gold medalist and a favourite perhaps for an Olympic gold medal as well. Rekindling a junior partnership with Allison to great effect. Perfect playing conditions, and those of you watching in the UK will be saying to yourselves, yeah, it's almost as sunny in Brazil as it is over here. Just turning into spring now in the UK. Quite the heat we've got here in Brazil, though, has to be said. Plenty of heat being delivered on court, although that was the error I was talking about at the start of this game that Alisson is prone to, and he's made one. That cross-court angle that he tries to employ doesn't always go well, and that one didn't. Didn't go too well for Nikolai either, did it? Nice serve from Bruno, good whip through the ball. And a big block from Alisson. His idols, in particular Ricardo, was renowned for this type of block of just jumping up and then throwing the ball down. He's off the net slightly, jumps up for the height and then reaches and throws it down. Great block. Lupo the target once again. Oh, wonderful dig. Oh, nice block by Nikolai, showing that he's just as capable of Alisson at the net. And he's not to be taken lightly. Nice play from Italy. Excellent block again from Nikolai. They know that that is an area they can exploit against Alisson, and they are going to try and do it as many times as possible. Making him hit, getting him into that mindset where he wants to try and hit his way out of trouble, only to find Nikolai in the way with the block. This time, though, Alisson finds a way past. So an interesting battle developing between those two. Alisson is the attacker and Nikolai is the blocker. Brazil will be happy with the way things are going currently with their three-point advantage. Well, Lupo couldn't find the line, so Nikolai shows him how it's done. Swing. Well, he's known as the mammoth, but he is a hulking character, isn't he? Alisson. You certainly wouldn't want to make him angry. You definitely wouldn't like him when he was angry. Bruno with the serve. Oh, that's a cracker, just though. Inches away from that sideline. The spidey senses of Lupo, sensing the danger but alert to it, letting it go. This time it's block out. Alisson is very much aware of the presence of Nikolai as he flies above that net. Superman-esque, getting his hands across but couldn't send it down. So the technical timeout, Brazil have the lead in a game that is by no means comfortable. It's tight to the net. It's going to be Allison's ball. Nothing at all that Lupo could do about that. It's all going great guns at the moment, isn't it, for Brazil? But right now, the Italians can't get themselves up and running. That's better. We'll block out something for Alisson to think about. Time for Italy to regroup. Serves like that, they can't. You cannot give cheap points against the number one seeds on their home turf and expect to get away with it. Oh dear, that was a taxi for Bruno. He has a long look at that. Fine line, and I know if you're sat at home watching and thinking, oh, how have they missed their serve? Why are they doing that? Well, it's the risk reward that you can potentially score a point from that serve without anybody having to help you, without you then having to play any defense behind it. Certainly for Brazil right now with this 4-point lead, it's something that will become more prevalent with their serving as they look to crank it up perhaps earlier in the run. Tight, too tight, no chance at all for Lupo. He was pushed wide and tight to the net. The angles were running away from him. He couldn't even get block out.
Time out for Italy.
So the timeout called as the players go and get themselves in the shade, get rid of that moisture that they will have, particularly on the forearms as well. It's one thing that then gets transferred onto the ball, which is why that the ball system that's being used here, as soon as it, there's the three ball system, as soon as that ball goes out of play, it's toweled down and presented back to the players, because that those moist arms that then get onto the ball can make setting very tricky and can also sometimes be a little embarrassing when the ball slips through your fingers on what looks like a pretty innocuous set. And as you can see, Lupo making sure that he will not be suffering with those problems as well. But also as well, when you're passing the ball to your own player, that can cause problems for them. So constantly trying to make sure that the sweat stays off the body, out of their eyes as well, off their arms. Brazil 5 points up, looking very good in this first set. What have Italy got to offer in response? Well, not very much at the moment. You just love those as a blocker. A little overpass, and you can go with the fist of fury.
Excelente passagem do Bruno Servius.
Oh, that is an absolute monster block. But somehow it's gone down the side of Nicolai. Well, first glimpse is where we thought, and I'm sure you did as well, wherever you're watching from, but that was a huge block. It was, but look at that, right down Nikolai's side. No wonder he's holding his hands to his face. Good up from Bruno. Great finish. That's what the crowd want to see. The crowd long for more of that. And now they are on their feet in anticipation as it's set point. Italy scrambling. Oh, that's a good ball. Brazil having to work hard. Free ball back here. Lupo not taking the chance to go over on two. And it's still in play. Alisson's not letting it come back, is he? And when it does, Bruno gets onto it magnificently. Oh, what a way to finish the first set. That was truly amazing. 21-13, Brazil totally dominant. And the fans going bonkers. So first set statistics, and it's good reading for Brazil. Four blocks to two, four more attacks, one more error by Italy, and an ace from Alisson. That got things off to a flyer, didn't it, for Brazil? Players back out for the second set. Lupo to serve. Cross-court block signalled by Nicolai. So that's a tough ask, taking away 90% of the court in the air. And a hard swing to the line from Bruno. He may only be short. And when I say short, 185, 6'1". On a net, that's 243. But he is a real jack-in-the-box, isn't he? As he gets up and over the net to swing hard on that line shot. Bruno making that court seem very small. Oh, and that's a little bit of luck, is it? Well, it looked in, but it has in fact missed on that baseline. And there is no luck at all for Italy. It was the pace. It was too much for Italy to handle, and Lupo couldn't keep it in play. Bruno once again. Interesting set, and the pokey will be way long. It just seemed that that ball moved a little bit too far in front of Nicolai, but he got away with it. However, Brazil get the point. Bruno. Free ball for Brazil. Oh, that's fantastic. What hops from Bruno. springs 4 feet. And a timeout called by Italy, 4-0. Is there any way back already in this set? Things for sure, watching these two at their best, it's very difficult to name a team who can live with them when they're playing this well. I'll tell you what, there's very few people who can manage that either, unless you're a boxer, by putting the ice pack on the back of your neck.
Permanece no serviço mágico.
It's an ace serve as he bangs that ball down to the baseline. But it's looking like this is going to be one of those games for Bruno and Alisson where everything they touch is turning to gold. Alisson apologises, he looked like he was going to break it, also just looked as if he lost his footing a little bit as he made that decision, and that just became a free swing then for Lupo. Lovely, really good bump set from Bruno. He gave that enough height and also enough width, not too far wide, but just brought it inside, that allowed that line shot option for Alisson. First time he's really hit that today. It just keeps piling on the pressure here as far as Italy are concerned. And Bruno with a lovely little flipper and a magnificent cut shot. Oh, he just fails to find that sideline. That would have been spectacular, wouldn't it? It was a great dig. Not quite the finish he wanted. But even so, Italy struggling to find any clean winners. Well, it's certainly a great display of beach volleyball from Bruno. And wherever you might be sat or standing in the world, whoever you might be watching with, whether you're on a date, perhaps sat in front of the laptop or watching it on TV, you are being royally entertained by Bruno and Alisson, arguably the best duo in the world of volleyball, up against a team which actually, as far as the tour players are concerned, find a team extremely difficult to play against. Very talented pair who have the respect and admiration of the entire men's tour. It's all credit really to Bruno and Alisson that they are giving them that ultimate respect and playing their best volleyball. And right now their best volleyball is too good for Italy. Look at that set, that is nectar, isn't it, from Bruno. And right now Alisson is feasting on his butter with those spikes. It is just a joy to watch. As a result for Lupo, trying to make sure he gets it past the block, he's having to roll it too high, and quite frankly Bruno could have had a cup of tea before he went running after that one, and then puts it away with ease.
Mais volta, ele no porto e a montanha aqui.
Oh, how did he manage to get away with that? It looked like he was going to roll cross court, and then he decided to go back into the block, and for a split second it looked like he'd actually put it in the net, but there was just enough of a gap, wasn't there, between Nikolai and the net that the ball was able to go down his shirt. So a little bit of luck for Bruno, but he won't be too worried about that. He's now going to go back and try and cause more trouble here for Italy with his jump serving. And juggling that one, but to no avail. Net seems to be getting impossibly high, doesn't it, for Italy right now? I guess if Danny Kinder was watching, he'd be saying, how are we supposed to beat Brazil on a high net? It's all about the contact points. Unfortunately for Italy from serve, they're not really causing enough problems. That looked to be on the line. And the line judge going with the Italians. The fans not too happy about it, but Lupo says, yeah, it's in. Lupo needs to get away from that. He needs to be focusing on his serve now. The ball actually has to hit the line, same as it does indoors. Lovely arm swing, gets up, gets across, and given the benefit of the doubt. Cross-court block signalled by Nikolai. As Alisson comes in, does well to drive back out to give himself space to come in, but he only manages to bury that into Nikolai's block, and he had loads of line to work with. He'll be arguing the ball was probably a little too far inside. He does have a tendency to jump up and not really jump forward, which is pretty much standard stuff for beach volleyball anyway. As Lupo comes with a little 1 foot jump float serve, which is normally reserved for indoor. Bruno tidies up. Brazil stay 5 ahead. And are on course for what's going to be a memorable gold medal for them to do it on home soil. It's up to Italy to try and derail Brazil here. Good touch, good play. But it's another big block from Nikolai, who just gets in the way of Alisson. Tells you all you need to know, don't you? Brazil score another point, and in style. And we hit the technical timeout. And right now, the battle of the biceps at the net is being won by Alisson, and in defence by Bruno. And at the moment as well, it's Italy just a sprinkling of points. They can't find a run of points, and that's the problem. This is most definitely Brazil's game to lose right now, should they switch off. Italy have got to dig deep and try and find something, a spark, anything, to turn it back in their favour. Easier said than done. Talked about when you look at this kind of sport. It's 37 degrees in the air, it's hotter than that on the sand, and it can be like walking on hot coals. But these guys, well, I guess they've got feet like the hobbits from Lord of the Rings, haven't they? leather feet, don't feel it. After a while you get used to it. But sometimes when it gets particularly hot, then you might see the sand socks come out. So in between sets, the volunteers will come in and hose down the courts to keep it a little bit cooler. So Italy with a couple of points. That's what they need to do now. If they can keep outscoring Brazil 2-1, then they would go on to take this set. At the moment, though. Nice take from Bruno. He wanted to have another go, and he does. That might well have been going long if you look at where Lupo was stood, and he's played that above his head. I'm not sure the ball had enough topspin on it to have brought that down in court. And that's when you've really got to commit. If you decide to try and go after that ball, it's got to come back into play. They're going to go after Nicolai here. Well, that's what Alisson wanted. So he's had to change his blocking call now from line to cross court. It doesn't matter though, because Bruno is hoovering everything up in that back court. He's seeing it in slow motion. He's knowing what Italy are going to do before they do. Game, you just can't take your eyes off it for a moment, can you? And I know those of you that might have been giving you youngsters that are watching and loving your beach volleyball, and mum and dad have given you chores to do. Maybe you're up tidying your room, and I bet you've got one eye on the computer still watching this. I'm sure they'll give you 5 minutes. This is probably all it's going to take, I think, now for Brazil to get this one done. 16-11. They're 5 points from victory. They're 5 points from the gold medal. Bruno just giving Alisson his blocking target. So a little bit of luck for Nicolai. All the focus seems to be on Brazil at the moment. And if you're an Italian fan, you've got to be thinking to yourself, come on, lads. You know you can do this. You're talented, lads. You've won gold medals before. You're 2-2. You're 3-3. That's 6 games, and they're tied 3-3. They know that they're not overawed by Alisson and Bruno. The occasion isn't certainly anything that would overawe them anymore. They're well into this game now. They just need to find a rhythm, find something to stop Brazil. But every time they do, Brazil come up with something different. This time, Alisson pops it up for Bruno to hit the second ball. That means that Nicolai is running laterally to try and make a block, so he can't get there. And right now, Brazil have all the answers to every question that Italy have asked them.
Nice shot, Daniele Lupo. Categoria do Lupo. 13-17. É isso,
from Alisson, but an excellent block from Nicolai. Well, he is a block monster, isn't he? He's brought the beach, or the indoor blocking game, to the beach. He, Alisson, Dalhauser, Evandro, Ricardo, at his very best, all able to get up, but more importantly, able to get across the net and into the space of the opposition attacker. Nice pass that from Bruno. And again, it's another one where the ball has been hit so quickly that Nicolai's not been able to close the block. He's not been able to seal the gap between himself and the net. So it's gone straight down his own side. So another point for Brazil, and despite their best efforts, Italy are being blinded by the light, the dazzling play of Brazil. And actually, there's a little break here as Nicolai just goes off to sort himself out. Definitely hat weather here, although for the fans, they've all been given visors, which I guess is okay if you've got a full head of hair. Definitely need some cream on if you don't. Nice, that's better. Lupo, almost a kind of don't care attitude with that swing, wasn't it? But he does care. His country cares. His fans care. Bruno trying to match Lupo. So no match point brought up just yet. Although the larger lady is gargling on the water, as it were, ready to burst into song. How long can Italy keep her in the wings? Little help from the tape. And it's now gold medal point for Brazil. Everyone on their feet. Bruno for gold here in Vitória. Lupo keeps it in play. And he comes up with a lovely little cut shot. But is he only delaying the inevitable? The fans that are watching screaming, Forza Italia. But it's now or never. Their backs are firmly to the wall as Nicolai gets ready to serve. One last charge, perhaps. Well, they're still in it. Bruno overcutting that one. Classic error, really. When you're going to the line, you've got to hit top spin. If you put a side spin on it, it's going to help it out. That's what happened. So, 1 point saved. Nicolai goes back again. And a timeout called. And a time for the players to sit down and take it all in, clear the sand from everywhere. And I can tell you now, there is sand everywhere. Italian fashion, the only things that can be said really is die, die, come on, come on. If they're going to stay in it, they need a point here. Brazil looking for that side out, looking for that gold medal. That's a really good pass from Alisson. He's got a swing for the match, and he's done it. It is gold for the number one seeds. Alisson and Bruno delight the home fans here in Vitória. They have beaten Italy by 2-0. Current world champions and the pretenders to the Olympic crown have taken gold in Vitória at the Open.